Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. Today we are back again with improving our chess with free chess software part 2. Let's look into it.
So as you saw in the first video, we have already installed CID versus PC soft application on our machines, and on top of that we have added the Kesa base data chess database into it along with the Stockfish engine. So today Roshan will be going over how we can use the Kesa base database to improve our chess.
Exactly. Thanks, Ravi. Basically, I hope all of you have ready with your setup. So once you are ready with your setup, like go to Kesa base, click on this and open this database. So double click here to open the Kesa base software, right? So it'll open in SID, right? And it'll come up like this. So basically now you are like, okay, just a board. Where do I find out what are the game lists? You told me I downloaded 4 million games. Where can I find them? To find them, you'll have to go on game and then list all games. So once you list all games, here you can see in the below part, it says that 4.02 million games are there. And each game here you can see. Now you're like, okay, this is there. Oh, exactly, I do get it on the board. So you right click on the game and say load. So once you load it, you can see the game part is here. But you're like, where are the moves? I'm not able to understand. So for that, you'll have to open a pigeon window. Go to Windows, click on pigeon window, and you can see the pigeon window here. But again, it's not very much aligned. It's a board is here, pigeon window is here. So for this, what you have to do is right click on the pigeon window, say move to right, so that it comes adjacent to the main window. So now let's go back to the board window. You can see the details of the match here. So this match was particularly played in 8/10/2018, and the white is a particular player rated 21-90 and black is 24-09, and white has a title of Women FM and the black has a title of IM. So you can see the moves here and you're like, oh wow, that's good, I'm able to have a particular game's database. Right, so you are like, okay, that's good, but there are matches. Oh, okay, I can see games. Maybe I could have seen it somewhere else also. Oh, exactly, I can improve this, right? So this is where we say that, okay, these are just games, but you can use all this database to improve your opening repertoire. Right, now I'm going to show you exactly how to do it, all right? So now let me do a new game. So this goes off. So in the new game, I for per se play this opening. I do also know that Ravi plays this opening, where it is e4, e5, knight f3, basically a four knight variation, which I think is a very much common among all of us, right? You can see the pigeon is here and you play this variation and opponent gets this, you take here, and then this is a very common variation where you give the check here and the pawn covers it up and pawn takes it back. And the most common here is bishop comes back to e7, right? But here is a very tricky move. You can do a queen f2, right? This is the queen f3, pardon. So basically this is a very unique position, right? So you're like, okay, wow, this is something I play. I want to know exactly how many games have been played in this position. This is the opening repertoire that you have. You want to know how exactly how many games have been played here. For that, what you have to do is go to search, click on search and click on current board and select your database, which is Kesa base that you have, and click on search. Once you do this, yeah, don't save, go back to your list. So all these games have been played in this exact situation. So you can see out of your 4.2 million games, there are 752 games which have been played in this exact position. So if you're someone who wants to go in this line, this could be amazing. Now you're like, okay, I don't have time to go through over 752 games, right? It is too much. Like maybe it is, I cannot go through it every day, right? So you will say that I want something, a window which would help me. For that, what you have to do is click on Windows, click on tree window, right? You can see here at this current position, 250 out of 752 games, black played Rb8 the highest number of times. 297 times RB8 was played, and the score is 43% of it. 43% of it is being played like this. So if you are a player who plays this opening through Y, you have to prepare your opening repertoire like this. Like, let's say if someone plays RB8, all right, say try new variations, try variations. And here you can see the database shows you what are the moves that you can be done. Right, Ravi, what do you think? This will help you?
Yeah, this is it. Nice. But I was also thinking now, since we have this, since it just gives a score of the score, as in it just gives us the win percentage, how do we know how exactly good that game is? Because win percentage is just going to be the number of games won by those people. Is there a way to include the engine which we have downloaded here?
Yeah, wonderful, wonderful question. That also you can do. So you go to your tools section here, click on tools, click on analysis engine, and click on the Stockfish 12 that you have added here into your SCI versus PC software, and click on start. Once you do this, you'll be able to see here, and then you can also move it to right. You also want it to be here. So now let's go back to your board. You can see your Stockfish evaluation. Here it is giving that plus 1.1 for white. So this is how a particular position you can prepare. So in this, there are different moves that you know what can be done. You know the perfect evaluation. You can probably work around all this. So you can go your BD3. And then it shows the next best moves for black. So if you're a white player, you can prepare to all these 9 moves. H6, Bishop E7, BD6. And you can know how exactly I should respond to when I make a certain move. And then you can click on restart here. And then you can see the evaluation. It says that H6 is the best move. And H6 has been played 70 number of times. And you can also see Bishop E7 is an alternative, which is the second most move that we. This is how professionals actually build their opening repertoire. And this is something that we casual players didn't know. We used to know opening theory maybe for 5-6 moves, then we stop it. Because we do not know what are the best moves. This is the advantage of having a database where we know, okay, these are the moves that people are playing who are at a title players or the top rated players are playing. And this is how we can develop our opening repertoire.
That's really nice. Yeah, this is amazing. But I have a problem here. Like the database which we downloaded, it's like 400 MB. But if I'm looking at this one opening, I don't think that it shows the 7 games. Is there a way to, you know, filter out from the openings or from the 4 million games that there are?
Yes, it's another wonderful question. Guys, of course, you can go to game, click on new game. Once you do this, you can put out the opening moves here. Like let's say any other move, your random moves are making here. So in this is the opening that you play, imagine. You can go to search and click on current board. That will show you the games which are there in your database in the current position. But I understand it could be tiresome for everyone to do this, and it doesn't make sense. People want a specific opening database. For that, we have another wonderful solution, another wonderful open source website, which is pgnmentor.com. You can see it will be there in the description, and you can see here also the file name. So here you can find the PGN files according to a particular player, particular opening, or particular events. Let's say if you want to look for a particular player, like who's maybe Magnus or anyone, you can find the players here, or anyone from the past who's very good, Nepomachi, all these legends you want to find, you can download their games. Also, you can go to a particular opening. Like you can see a modern opening. So all these games, 13,542 games of modern openings have been there here. So you can just download it here. And once you download it, all right, now I'll show you. In this way, you can download any of the things. So I and I think Ruhul play Smith Mora a lot. So I have downloaded here Smith Mora. All right, so you just download it, extract it. You can see it here, and it'll be in this format. You just you can click here and it'll open. Or another way of doing it is you can go to file. You can go back to your software. You can say file open, and you can come to your Smith Mora file and then just click open on it. So once you do it, you have to go to game list. Here down, can you see? Here you'll be seeing a Kesa-based software. Your database, which has 4.02 million games. And here you can see a new one, which is Smith Mora PGN, right? So all these games are of Smith Mora. Here you can see, and if I want to load this up, I can load it up, and it will be in my board, right? So I can just, you can see the Stockfish here, you can see the tree base here, the E4, D4, I mean, basically you get into the Smith-Morra-Weiss. So here you can see what are the moves that have been played out, and there are so many games and you can develop from there. Like now in the Smith-Morra, and the tree that is showing here is for the Smith-Morra. So basically you can make out what are the exact moves for each move that you're developing. Like you can take here, you cannot take here, DXC moment move, or you can play NF6. So if you're a player who plays as white, these are the options, 15 options that black has chosen for this exact position. And each position you can improve. So you just do try variation to any of these things. So once you take on DXC, these are the 4 or 5 moves that have been done. And that you can evaluate according to the engine also. Of course, Smith-Morra is an attacking gambit line. That's why Starfish 12, which is a strong engine, gives advantage to black. But of course, this we can, I think, a lot of title players also play. And I think in casual players, this can be a really good opening if you're an attacking player. So I think this should give you guys a general overview of how you can use all the setup to, let's summarize what we have learned here. So all this you can use to build your opening repertoire, understand and read games with the help of engines of top players and so many other rated players in your database, download specific opening database from PGN Mentors, and from there use tree window, which is very, very important, guys. Tree window will give you number of moves that are there in a particular position, and that will help you to improve your opening repertoires. And I hope you like this part of the video. In the next video, we'll teach you guys how you can build your own database from the games that you've played in your online platforms, be it chess.com or LeeChess. How you can put the database here, save it, and you can do so many other things. How do you update your database? So that part will be coming in the part 3.
So I think, thank you, Roshan and Ravi, for your wonderful explanations and our questions. And probably, guys, if you have any queries, do put it in the chat, do put it in the comment sections, and we will respond to them immediately. And this is my team, Corporate Chess India. Thank you, Ravi. Thank you, Roshan. And we are signing off. And thank you, guys. Do like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you. Thank you once again. We'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.